made you some content. Daddy made you your favorite open wide. Here comes the content. It's a beautiful day to stay inside.
Greg's Mood Killers, Eddie with Marconi. This, I found this new app, and it's not good that I found this app because I'm a little obsessed with it, but not in a bad way. But I think I'm going to delete it. It's basically this app that allows you to buy lottery tickets.
Oh, no.
And, you know, it doesn't feel like it's real money because it's on an app and it, you know, connects to your bank card. I never buy lottery tickets, though. I'm not
okay.
A lottery
You're obsessed
person.
With it, so you've played the lottery a few times. Have you won anything?
No.
Yeah.
I probably wasted about $20 on this app so far.
Why not just throw your phone in the toilet? Basically the same.
I know. It's stupid. Like, I feel like the lottery is such a waste of money. And I know like a lot of people love to play. And you know, as long as you're not spending money that you need, it's fine. Have fun. I know that it goes to good causes, you know, whatever. I don't know. I just, this app really should go to hell, though, because they make it too easy. To buy a lottery ticket.
Oh, like there's no, like, it's sort of like anything. Like, it's so weird that you can just order food on your phone and like
right.
buy a million different things. Like, I've done the thing now where you do on Amazon where I'll just put something in my shopping cart and like 5 or 6 days later, I'll decide if I really need it, you know?
Because yeah,
sometimes
yeah.
you'll just put something in there and you're like, I don't really think I need this.
But, if I'm on the edge, I'll leave it in the shopping cart. And then yeah. if I come back to the item, I might say, oh, I'll save for later. Or because it's just so easy on every app to spend money because it,
yes.
none of it feels real is the problem. And
but then,
the same thing was happening to me with the sports betting apps, too. I was on one of those at the beginning of the football season and I put $50 into it thinking, oh, you know, just it didn't feel like real money. And then I lost it all. And then it hit me that I just wasted $50 on nothing.
I know. And you tried
and
to get
I'm like,
me.
This is stupid.
You invited. I think you sent me an invite for like a free play or something
yeah.
like that. I'm like, I'm not doing that because I know it'll be like, you know, oh, I won $10. Maybe I could do another 10. You know,
I get greedy with it too. Like I'm not a good gambler. So
it's
if
never
I,
enough.
It's never enough. If I double $20, I'm like, oh, I got to do it again, and then I always lose. Like I'm terrible with it.
So
I have to delete this lottery.
Yeah,
app.
Do it right now.
It's got
do it.
Yeah,
do it right now.
Delete it right now.
Yeah,
there we go.
Now, there are great. I just need. You know what I like? I like games on phones that are like those puzzle games where like the chunks fall down and you have to line up the blocks together. I can't remember
oh, yeah.
what the name.
It's called Chunks Fall Down. I like that game.
It's fantastic. Yes.
Find Mood Killers on social media. Of course, if you have Instagram, you also have Threads. So follow us, Mood Killers, on both of those glorious platforms. We haven't done entertainment news in a while, so why don't we see what's going on with entertainment? Oh, celebrities. We love them. Or something. I don't know. I think we're contractually obligated as a morning show to talk about celebrities occasionally, right?
I don't, because some people hate celebrities because they have
yeah.
political thoughts that are different from people. So they've decided to swear off and say that, you know, Hollywood elites and all that stuff. That's not why we don't like celebrities. We don't like celebrities because just like everyone, they're mostly a-holes. But then
yeah.
occasionally
and it's just like attention seeking sad people. And I see the sadness
yeah.
in their eyes, all of them.
Yeah.
There's a couple of good ones. We do have a list on this show of celebrities that are cool.
Yeah.
But it's just very few and far between, though, when you look at the whole picture of Hollywood.
Now, as he goes into retirement, Jason Kelsey, would you say he's one of those celebrities that you'd like? I don't think one person has said they don't like him.
Yeah, I don't have anything against Jason Kelsey. I think we need to get to know him a little bit more in the public eye. Like, I don't know what his personality is really like.
Watch his podcast. That podcast is one of the best things I've seen.
Oh, like right. He does do a pretty popular podcast.
Yeah.
Brother yeah. there. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
There's some breaking celebrity news.
Famous.
That's right. Go check out the Kelsey Brothers podcast.
It's called New Heights.
Oliver Stone is in trouble. Did you know this? Did you hear about Oliver Stone?
Okay, Oliver Stone was the guy. He used to be a director everybody would talk about. And I don't know. I can think of one movie. He did Platoon? Is that the movie he did? And then...
He did JFK. Yeah, Platoon, right. Natural Born Killers.
Yeah, and it used to be like a pretty big deal. He's still alive, Oliver Stone? Because I think he was like in his 70s when he did JFK Jr. or a movie or whatever that JFK movie.
Yeah, he's around and he's talking crap about Ryan Gosling. He says that Ryan Gosling wasted his time with the movie Barbie.
Oh, the movie he won a Golden Globe and all that. All he's saying
nominated for an Oscar.
I mean, it was a very popular movie. I guess maybe Oliver Stone only thinks in certain movies that he likes are good. That's a problem too. Is some directors, they only think that their way of thinking is the way people should think, and I don't know. I think Ryan Gosling's doing okay with his career.
I don't know. Oliver Stone isn't approving of it. So, you know, you might want to switch things up, Ryan. You're not doing good enough. Okay. Your Oscar nomination, being in the biggest movie of the year last year. Do better, Ryan Gosling.
Well, and he wasn't
famous.
Yeah.
He was in La La Land too, right? And wasn't he in that Notebook? He's had so many movies that kid has done.
Yeah, he's not a kid. Oliver Stone said he's not doing good enough, so he's not doing good enough. I'm sorry.
Well,
wanna be famous.
Celebrities, what the hell are they doing? The director of Fiddler on the Roof dropped dead. His name, Norman.
Like 4 weeks, like 2 months ago. Like,
why is this dead? And this is coming across the wire today, so maybe it
the
was
wire.
Backed up. I don't know.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Oh, maybe it was the actor. Newsroom. I don't know.
It came across on the telegram just now.
And the Fiddler on the Roof is the "If I Were a Rich Man," dee 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 dee. That guy?
Yeah.
That's it? Okay. That's all. I don't.
That guy dropped dead.
I don't believe I know. I don't think I've seen that. But I know it's popular.
I guess. Yeah, I haven't seen it either, actually. It's supposed to be a classic. I haven't seen it. But yeah, so that.
You know
guy.
What I'm watching? I'm rewatching Sopranos right now, and it's the greatest thing ever. I don't think I'll ever stop. I take about six to maybe once a year. I just rewatch it, the whole thing from start to finish, and then I get bummed out when these shows are over because I'm like, well, I could start on a new show, but then I start on a new show and I find myself scrolling through my phone on some new shows. So I'm like, why don't I just, if I'm going to scroll, why don't I just watch a show that I've already watched and I know I like? And so is that what getting old is? Is that what's happening? Or do I just
watch the same TV shows over and over again? I think so. I think that's a sign. That's a sign.
Or it's just a sign that I know what I like and I don't need to, because some of these shows are really good. Like I'll get into like a new show. Like I told you, I was into Riverdale and, you know, shows that like no man would normally watch.
You watched Rick and Morty? They just announced season 8 is coming in 2025.
No, because that whole thing with Justin Roiland kind of put me off. So I'm over with that.
Well, wasn't he? He was fired.
Yeah, I know. But he still makes money off of it. And I don't know what he was. The charges were dropped against him. It was some kind of a
charges. I didn't know he had charges. I thought he was just fired for being a jerk around the.
No,
the like
some woman. I brought allegations or something. I can't remember what the whole thing was about. You know, abuse. Maybe it was an ex-girlfriend or something, and they dropped him. But you know, it's his co-creation, so he still makes money off of it. So like, same with that solar show. What's the solar eclipse show or the. I can't remember. It's the other alien cartoon show. It's on Hulu. And it was really good. I was into that. But then I was put off by that whole Justin Roiland thing. And so now I don't know why they didn't just end Rick and Morty. Do we need more episodes?
Oh, they didn't end it because I think these allegations came out right when they locked it in for a huge contract. And so they basically just recast his voice. So the show continues on without him.
With a new guy that's going, it's almost like at this point, the voices are almost like, you know, everybody can do a Cartman. So maybe.
Exactly. So it's not going to be hard to recast. I think they already found somebody pretty easily. So.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's a clever show, though. I like it. And it's coming back in 2025. That's celebrity news. Look at that. We have.
No thanks.
No thanks. Marconi says no thanks.
Famous. I want to be famous.
Eddie, you know, I like to share with you some of my most intimate thoughts. These are my Marconi loves.
Okay.
I exercised for a whole hour and a half. It wasn't all on the same day, but still. You know?
Oh, yeah.
Is an hour and a half a week, is that enough? I mean, I always wonder.
It's a start. I don't know. What do they say? 30 minutes a day or something? Even 20 minutes a day is good.
But so then, you know, actually,
an hour and a half is that if you add it up, you worked out like 3 or 4 days worth.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what I think is enough. Honestly, yeah, I'm not trying to be an Olympian, but the other thing, then they'll tell you, you know, to walk instead of like running is something you could do early on, but as you age, it's not good for you. And I find
as a teenager, I couldn't run. It always hurt me. I never liked running ever.
And I never really liked it, but for whatever reason, it made me feel good. Like when I did
Oh, no, the endorphins are real. Like I love to get out and ride my bike, though, because it's a lot easier on my body. And it's the same concept because it's like you're getting the cardio in, you know.
If I could ride my bike like when I was a kid, you know, you'd ride it and everywhere. And,
yeah, yeah.
And it, like, you know, riding on the sidewalk wasn't a big deal. And now it's like they want you to ride in the middle of traffic where people are texting on their phones and, you know, ramming into you. I don't want to die that way. So it's so frustrating because I do like a bike. But
I don't know. In the summertime, I ride almost everywhere. Well, I mean, if, not like if I'm going to the grocery store or something.
Yeah.
But I like to ride around.
I would be okay if they just replaced, you would take your car only for road trips. And there were special roads just for bikes, not lanes. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I like when you have those trails that go from place to place. That's
yeah,
great.
I stick to those usually.
Yeah.
Because it's safer. You know, I don't want to get into traffic. It's the same thing because people do not pay attention. There's so many times I've almost been hit by people that aren't looking at the road. So
it's bad enough if you're walking, people still run into you. It's like, well, pay attention. Stop looking at your dumb phone. Okay, here's another one of my Marconi logs, Eddie. Most people think T-Rexes, you know, the dinosaur, can't clap because they have short arms, but really, it's because they're dead.
Okay.
Mind-blowing.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I like to put it all out there.
No, yeah. That was that's changing lives.
I don't understand all the fuss about ChatGPT. I have teenage nieces and nephews who already know everything. We're going to be fine. This is something I haven't really shared on the show, but Eddie, I don't know if you knew this or not. I haven't even told you. Emma Stone is my girlfriend. But please don't tell her. I want it to be a surprise. Yeah. For a second, you almost believed that I was being serious.
I know. How lucky would you be?
She's amazing. She loves Taylor Swift,
I've always
too.
Had a crush on her. Isn't she? Yeah. Something about her.
And she's great. She's great at acting. And I think she has
You have to watch the new thing she's in with Nathan Fielder called The Curse.
Yeah, which platform is that on?
I found it on Amazon.
Okay.
And I'm watching it on there, and it's really strange. I have no idea where it's going. It might be a little bit of a horror theme, but I don't know. I'm confused by it.
You're watching? Is it a series then? It's not a movie?
Yeah, it's a series.
Oh, wow. And so is the entire thing available right now, or do I have to wait each week?
The whole thing's out, and it's about this couple. It's her, Emma Stone, and Nathan Fielder, and they just got a deal with HGTV to make this home renovation show. But then you see the behind the scenes about how they're just terrible people, and They are putting themselves in really bad situations, and I won't ruin it for you, but it's...
So she's a perfect person playing a terrible person. I might be in love.
Yeah.
Okay.
Eddie, as I said before, I am sharing with you some of my most intimate thoughts. These are my Marconi logs. Now, I give these to you. I write things down, and sometimes I just share them on the air because, I mean, where else am I going to say this stuff? So,
right.
I mean, there's no, remember Twitter? I used to write this stuff like on Twitter. And now there's no Twitter, so I got to have an outlet. I tried it on Threads. That barely works. Sometimes people will like it, but, you know, post it on Facebook. And I don't think, sometimes it goes right over people's heads. They don't really connect with these things. So here I am. If people are going to be not get it, I might as well be on radio where I don't have to worry about the like button, you know?
Yeah. And why give your content for free to Mark Zuckerberg? I mean, here.
That's right. Do it for free on the show.
Getting paid for it here.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, do it for free here. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Or whatever.
Here we go. Agent. Here's another one, Eddie. I'm in charge of the team building activity for our next staff meeting. I guess we're all getting new bidets. So, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Imagine,
wouldn't that be great? That would be a team bonding experience. You go out and try out bidets to see which ones are right for you. Like at the home improvement store. Everybody gets to sit down and, you know, see what's what. I mean, there are so many out there.
Brunch beforehand, do bidet, brunch and bidet.
Yeah, okay. maybe after. Yeah, brunch before, brunch after. Well, I don't know. Maybe bidet first. Because you understand what I'm saying? I mean, I get what you're saying. But if you maybe ate food first, you might really have to use the bidet. Now, I understand. But if you're going to a home improvement store, there need to be places where you can try these things out. You're right, though. So maybe that's an idea we could work on, Eddie. Home improvement store bidet section. Where you can actually go in the privacy of a booth and try it out.
Right.
Here's another one on my Marconi logs. I don't believe in lying to children unless it's about where the good snacks are hidden. Then that's fine. You don't want to put all your good snacks out if the nieces and nephews are coming over, you know? Just some. Enough to where you're kind of a popular uncle, like, oh, he has good ice cream. That. But, you know, but the peanut butter cups, I've got to hide those because they'll be gone.
Yeah. That's right. That's for daddy.
That's for daddy. That's a show I piloted. You know, I tried to get that during pilot season. Right. Yeah, a show called That's for Daddy. Oh, man. I was going to bring you in if it got picked up, but I haven't heard back. So maybe not.
Darn.
Here's another one, Eddie. Maybe you heard of this, too. When I was in elementary school, we learned about a shape called a rhombus. And that was the last time we ever heard about that shape ever again. What happened to the Roombas? Does it still exist? I don't know. I've never used it.
I don't know. Yeah, I haven't either.
Here's another one. Sorry I'm late. You always have to have an excuse when you're late. I don't know why, but this is a real one. I was chasing a pasta noodle around the sink with the faucet sprayer and lost track of my life.
That happens.
It really does. I hate when it sticks and you have to get in there, you know, like with your finger or something or a brush.
Uh-huh.
Not a fan of that. I don't like touching.
No.
Yeah. I don't know why, because it's just a pasta and water. You just maybe had it on your plate or in a, you know, maybe you're cooking it.
It sticks, you know, and then you spend all evening trying to get those things out of the side of the sink.
Yeah. It's been or in the pot. It's always stuck to the side of the pot, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah.
Here's another one, and maybe this one more can relate to. I don't even check my bank account anymore. I just swipe my card, and if it's meant to be, the money will get debited.
Everyone loves Stanley cups, you know, the little straw. So
they
I
do?
Thought we could do a Stanley cup update.
Clang, clang.
You know, and see what's going on in the world of Stanley cups.
A Stanley cup date?
A cup date. That's right. Stanley cup date. Parents spent $3,000 to get their 16-year-old every variety of Stanley Cup.
Oh, my God.
She now has 67 various styles and colors, and the teen is, quote, obsessed.
Of course, obsessed. Everyone's obsessed. I am
obsessed. I gotta get my Stanley Cup.
Part of my mentality, I feel the obsession with things. Like, like if a show comes out, like a new episode, like if Veronica Mars came back, I would be obsessed. You know, I was obsessed with Gossip Girl. I'm obsessed if Taylor Swift has a new album come out. I do get like that. So I understand that vibe, but I've never been obsessed over a water bottle.
I don't understand what's the whole thing. Why are people so infatuated with these water bottles? Where did it start? Like, you think it was just a couple of popular kids in a high school that really got the snowball headed down the hill? What is it?
Here's what happened, Eddie. And this is why people can't figure out, like, what about the hydro flask? What about this one and that one? The igloo? It's because of TikTok. TikTok has the power over everything. And that's why,
I assumed it was on TikTok. But it had to be, like, a couple of influencers, right? That started to talk about them?
Yeah. They had them, or they saw them, or they got them, and they were, like, making a big deal about it. And I'm guessing at some point there was some ad exchanged with some influencer, you know, like, so they were saying, you know, you do your videos and you use this cup, then this agency will give you a certain amount of money. And that's what happens. So,
I mean, whoever put together this marketing campaign for Stanley Cups, they are going to be having like the best career ever of all time.
And what I feel like it's reached the climax. So it's maybe, you know, it's there, but you know, it's coming down.
Here's a sign it's reached its climax. A woman was arrested for stealing 65 Stanley Cups.
I saw that. There was like they showed the picture, and it's like the back of a cop car with 65 different Stanley Cups on top. It's pretty weird.
Right. She stole $2,500 worth of Stanley Cups. 23-year-old woman just ruined her life over Stanley Cups.
Yeah. I mean, I was telling you, I've been watching Sopranos, and this the cycle of water bottles. We've always had them in that show, like the first and second season. They were shot in the late 90s. Do you remember a water bottle that was like a plastic bottle? And I can't remember if it was a bottle or if you just bought a giant water bottle, and then you had like this mesh net with a strap that you could put around your shoulder. And you could carry your water bottle.
Yeah. Well, wasn't that just a little carrier for an Algene, essentially? Isn't that what
maybe.
It was?
Yeah. And I don't even remember what Algene really is. It sounds like algae to me when you say it. But is that
it's a type of water bottle. I just have to say, anybody that's obsessed with these Stanley Cups, how about no? And have you ever tried going into your kitchen and just grabbing a glass out of the cupboard?
You can't carry that with you, Eddie. You can't take that in your car.
That's what they want you to think, is that you can't take that glass outside of your kitchen. But it will go outside the kitchen walls.
You know what's funny, too, is I was thinking about this. Like, you know, all these tumblers and this and that. It's strange to me because you look at all the ones from the past. Nobody cares about them. This trendy stuff, it's such a weird thing where people worry about what's trending and they have to be up to date with trends. And then, you know, they're going to grow up and maybe 20 years from now, they'll look, remember when we were into those Stanley Cups? Why were we obsessed with that? What's wrong with our brain?
It's dumb. So, it's like the new Beanie Baby or something.
Yeah. Yeah. Just do what Eddie said. Bring a cup from home. Like just regular old glass.
Go to the kitchen cover and grab a glass.
And so maybe if you have to have it covered, just put a piece of like some tape over it.
don't be clumsy.
That's right.
Be an adult. Grow up.
Ask Mood Killers.
Mood Killers. Okay. Let's see. The people want advice from Mood Killers. That's us, I guess.
Oh.
But we're not. We don't call ourselves the Mood Killers or anything like that. It's just the name of the show. We need to make that clear. But people do have questions for us.
I go around saying we're Mood Killers.
Do you? Do we get jackets that say the Mood Killers?
There's no the. It's
so,
like when Zuckerberg did Facebook, it was the Facebook, and they're like, no, it's just Facebook. Yeah. It's just,
right,
mood,
it's just
killers.
Mood Killers.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
Well, if you have a question for us, let us know. Email moodkillers@stayanal.com. Mood Killers, what's the best way to learn a new skill or a hobby? YouTube. I like YouTube. You can learn everything on YouTube. Isn't it great? I learned What's the last thing? I learned how to fix my garbage disposal on YouTube recently because it wasn't working. It was like making a weird noise. And I was like, oh, crap, this is going to cost me thousands of dollars. Went on YouTube and all I needed was basically like a wooden stick and I fixed it in 2 seconds. Thank you, YouTube.
Oh, my gosh.
Thank you.
Yeah. You unplugged it and everything and turn off the water. Do you have to turn off the water?
No, I didn't have to do that. It was a really simple fix that happens all the time to garbage disposals. They get off their little track or something. And
wow,
you just get a stick and you spin it around manually a couple times and it gets it back in gear. And yeah.
What I do,
I would have looked like such an idiot if somebody came over.
I just go to the website for my building and type in like a message to my maintenance guy. And within 2 minutes, he's up here. The only thing is like if you're in one of those days where you don't feel like having people in your house, but he's real good at getting in and out and he's real nice. So I don't mind. But yeah, sometimes I try to avoid, you know, bugging him just because I don't feel like being around people. So, nothing against him. He's a real nice guy. But
I always plan maintenance like that around. I try to make it happen on a day where I want somebody over. I never want somebody over. I have to have somebody come and look at my furnace. And I really am dreading it, actually, because I don't want it. It's going to disrupt my entire day.
Well, yeah, because they have a window just like anything. You know, I feel like, you know, when you live in a building, like I've always lived in apartments and stuff like that. It's great because there's a lot of things you don't have to think about. If a stove doesn't work, either somebody comes over and fixes it or they replace it. Or, you know, if an appliance breaks, they take care of it. But when you have a home, they should have like a business that just covers all of those things. Like you can just call a maintenance number. Like you have a club and you pay like $10.95 and they come over and fix it for you. And then you pay for parts if you need a part. Or maybe that's part of the deal. They have parts, you know, there for you.
$10.95. Come over and do anything I want. I like that.
Yes. I mean, there's so many different ways you can do it. But I mean, wouldn't it be nice if if there was just one business that took care of all of that? I mean, there's got to be.
I would love it.
Yeah, I would subscribe to that if I didn't have a maintenance guy. So
absolutely,
that's all I'm saying.
Well, we had a great time, as always, but every good thing comes to an end.
The party's over.
Oh, we talked about so many different things. We talked about Stanley Cups, because how can you avoid Stanley Cups? They're everywhere. You can't I don't have one yet, but I'm guessing I'll end up with one probably in like 3 or 4 years when they're not cool. Somebody will just hand me one, or it'll be like a promo item.
Yeah, I have so many swell bottles that have served me well.
Yeah.
And I just have way too many of them. And you know me, I don't like to throw things away because you're just adding to a pile. But I'm not hoarding them. I just have several. So I don't really have room for another cup. And I have
too many water bottles as it is. Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't need any more water bottles in my life.
Now, are you drinking enough water, though? Because you say
all day, like a baby needs his bottle, like it's like a baby.
That's right. baby needs a body sippy cup. That's what these cups are.
I feel like a toddler walking around with my sippy cup all day. Like it's not. People are too obsessed with drinking water. I know it's good, but like we've gone overboard.
We have.
You don't really need as much water as they say you need.
So you don't. Do you drink like
I do drink a lot of water.
Do you drink a pint of water before you go to bed? This is what I heard.
A pint?
You're supposed to drink about a pint of water before you go to bed. It's because for your heart.
I mean, I usually do drink water before bed. I don't know if it's a whole pint. That's I'll start doing that. A pint of water.
Yeah.
I like to drink a LaCroix before bed.
Yeah. I can't drink
I get
too
that
many
carbonation in my
this
system.
This is how sensitive my carbonation. I'm too sensitive.
Yeah.
I have to spread that out. I can only have like one or two a day of carbonation. And I love LaCroix, but sometimes I'll venture out and I'll have a San Pellegrino. The only problem with that, it's got a little sodium in it and I don't need that. So
you can't have that.
But so but I like to, you know, I drink my water bottle. I have water next to my bed at all times. And it's got me, you know, getting up and down throughout the night. How many times do you get up and down throughout the night?
I can usually make it the whole night and be fine.
You can?
Yeah.
Are you ready to explode when you get up, though? Do you have to run to the bathroom?
Yeah, some days. Some days it'll be like, uh-oh. But I usually try to go just before I go to sleep, like almost literally before I know I'm about to go to sleep.
Oh, yeah.
Just to make sure that everything's clear.
Do you brush your teeth while you're on the toilet, like when you're going?
Absolutely, yes. That's the most hygiene thing to do.
But yeah, I always have my night routine, and I've got to, you know, put on all my my lubricants. I got to, you know, lotion my face and neck. And my
there's a lot to do.
There's so much, and there's so many different types of things, lotions and things you have to put on, and I'm like,
getting ready for bed is just a monumental task, and it's annoying.
I
try to do it as efficiently as I can, but still, it's like, oh, gotta get ready for bed.
Because I got one of these Quip toothbrushes. It brushes your teeth just the right amount because it vibrates, and you don't have to, you know, it's a lot of people brush their teeth too hard. So, but it's nice because it gives that 2 minute limit, and you only need to brush your teeth for 2 minutes. So it's nice because I don't have to think about it. But sometimes microwaving a food, that's the longest 2 minutes of your life. I just want to go to bed. I know I need to brush my teeth so I don't, you know, go toothless. But the last thing I want to do is brush my teeth.
It's hell. Well, if you missed anything today and you want more of what you just heard.
If you want more.
If you want more, there's more where that came from. Get our podcast, moodkillersradio.com.
Oh, I hit the wrong button. Wait, hold on a second.
Oh, there you go. Moodkillersradio.com.
Moodkillers. Oh, my bed's too low. I'm going to have to hire a guy.